All right, so got a number of layers in this. I'm about to flatten it and then add the final highlights. I want to do a few things right before I do that, though. One is to go up to this layer, which is the highlight layer, and kind of clean up some areas where I don't think there should be highlights. At least not those highlights. Separate layer, I can go in and just erase back some stuff that I don't like. Kind of fix some things here and there. I'm actually going to come in and add highlights over some of this that I'm erasing. This is where you just want to go in and refine it, kind of hunting for anything that just doesn't make sense to what you're wanting to do. Do something that. And just a soft eraser, even though this is the instant erase, it's pressure sensitive. Some of these things back and make it look like the light's wrapping around and fading around. So. Alright, so we've got a number of layers. Don't normally work on a lot of layers, but this one's a little bit different for me, so. Merge all these down. You do that just by going into here, merge all layers. Now we've got all that on one layer, so it's pretty much like a dried painting. So I can go in, create a new layer, and paint on top of it. And this is where I'm going to look for things that I can really make it pop or change and adjust stuff. So I'm going to kind of work my way down from the top. Let's take it from the top, ladies and gentlemen. So, the pencil works good for this. The oil-free custom brush can work good for this. This is where I want to look for places, for example, to make this water sparkle. I use the pencil. I can add trickles, water sparkle. Really kind of pull it across these rocks. This time I don't have it set to overlay, so I'm just literally painting on top of the other paint. So that's why I don't get the green color kind of shining and stuff. It helps kind of clean up some of the edges. One thing I didn't notice was right here. That was where my overlay layer was. So I have an option. I can either undo everything I just did and go back and fix this, or I can just paint over it real quick. I think I'm going to paint over it real quick because I do like right here, for example, how that looks. So I'm going to change some of this a little bit as far as it doesn't look like the waterfall is there. Let's just buy spacing. I think it does kind of pull this forward nicely. So as Bob would say, that's one of those happy little accidents that you can just take advantage of. Lemons, throw them at the person that gave you the lemons. Oops. There we go. You just look for anything like that where you can break it up. Fixed. Didn't really have to go in and redo a whole lot. You're gonna make a mistake here and there. I really agree. Bob Ross coined that phrase of happy accidents, but it's true. If you just don't worry about it, it's not a big deal. You just start going, okay, well, so that's there. Let me fix it. How do I fix it? Oh, do this. So just don't stress about it. Stuff and not overly worry about it. Thank you. got some of that really kind of pulled together. Just this white color. Adding in shadows, but I'm kind of vignetting around the edges, which basically means darken the edges. Of what I was just doing there, which was a kind of a hot spot sunlight back and added. Okay, now I want to add some pops of color in here, so I'm going to add some flowers, and one of the ways to do that, textures, particles, and maybe throw in some blues. Thank you. thing. Now, one other thing I want to do to kind of finish this out is down here, I want to add some mist. So what I'm going to do is go back to my custom brush, watercolor brush. Layers. I think this works. So my interpretation of Takahashi's Waterfall, and you know, it's a good piece to practice with. So I think it turned out pretty good. So let me know if you have any questions, comments, or thoughts on it, and you know, what else you can learn from it. But like I said, ArtRage Vitae works really great. A little bit smoother than 6. It's got a few things that I don't like, but they're small. It's just because I'm used to ArtRage 6. But other than that, it's a really good program, and I recommend it really well. It or 6, I recommend. So I appreciate you watching. If you have any questions or comments, let me know. Thanks.